to research being done to fight cancer. We all know that chemotherapy and radiation kills cancer cells, but it also kills healthy cells, and scientists are now focusing their attention on gene therapy. And with us this morning is Margaret Cianci. She is the executive director of the Alliance for Cancer Gene Therapy. So thank you for being here this morning.
Good morning,
we appreciate
Brian.
It. So a lot of us have probably heard the words gene therapy, but we don't know what it is. So if you had to explain it, what exactly is gene therapy?
The idea of treating cancer just at the genetic level, where the cancer is growing in the genes in the cells. So if we can replace a bad gene, or if in fact we can get the immune system to actually respond to cancer cells just keep growing and growing.
Right.
If we can get the immune system to literally understand that they're supposed to be shutting them down, that's really, by using gene therapy, that's the best way to get it done. And we believe and have seen proof that in fact it's working.
And I was just gonna say, how do patients respond to this?
Well, it's so exciting. So we actually started the foundation over 13 years ago. But in that time, particularly in the last couple of years, we're now seeing tremendous response by patients, particularly in clinical trials for leukemia, lymphoma, melanoma. And in some cases, they literally are in complete remission after maybe only one treatment, which is one of the biggest benefits.
And all things considered, this gene therapy is fairly new.
It's very new. So most important is the fact that now, as we understand more about molecular medicine and understand more about the genome, that in fact led to all these different technologies, and the idea is to treat many cancers, not just one specific type.
So many people may be seeing this right now and wondering, am I eligible? How are you eligible for this?
It's such a good question. The most important thing is to try to get into a clinical trial, because there are so many being done now around the country. And of course, they're doing it at Yale, as well as a lot of our other Memorial Sloan Kettering, other local hospitals, but also at MD Anderson, at Dana-Farber in Boston. And so if you can get into a clinical trial and meet certain requirements, we've seen an adult patient who is in complete remission and was literally on death's door, or even better, a 9-year-old who is absolutely cancer-free from leukemia, and they really thought she was on her deathbed.
Wow, so the results are amazing from all of this.
Tremendous.
I mean, and I would imagine, are people skeptical sometimes going into it, and then they see the results and think, my God?
Well, I think as with any other new therapy, it's still in clinical trials, and we need to get more research so that in fact we can get it further along the process and get it to more patients and make it a drug. And so one of the therapies that we invested in with our researcher, very early stage, has now been fast-tracked by the FDA, meaning it's going to get a faster approval process and then hopefully be even available to more patients. So we're very excited about that.
Very good. Now tell us a little bit more about the Alliance for Cancer Gene Therapy.
So we affectionately call it ACGT, and actually those represent the letters that make up every DNA. They're the building blocks of every DNA strand. But it was founded in 2001 by Edward and Barbara Netter, Greenwich residents, and they really had this vision early on, when no one else was supporting these therapies, that if in fact we could do different types of treatments other than those, as you mentioned earlier, like chemo and radiation, that have such devastating side effects, if in fact we could support just this type of research, wouldn't that help move the research along? And hence now we see this boom in immunotherapies as an example, and that's really because of what they started over 13 years ago.
So it's certainly working. And how can people show their support for gene therapy?
Well, one of the best ways for us, of course, is to visit our website, acgtfoundation.org, and we need ambassadors, we need people to help spread the word via social media, Facebook, Twitter, but also we need donations. Supporting research, which is all we do, really helps move the process along and get more research to patients. Our goal is really to make cancer a manageable disease that people can live with longer, better qualities of life without all these devastating side effects. And if in fact we can get more money, that we 100% of all donations go straight to research. So you give us a dollar, you can be assured that that is supporting only research, and that's all we do.
Wow, good to know. So a lot of good certainly being done, and a lot of good being spearheaded by you guys. So thank you very much, Margaret, for joining us.
Thank you.